Hi guys, this is Ranjit and welcome to the first video of 2022. I hope you guys also have a great year. And here we have Jeep Compass. And here is the owner of Jeep Compass, Nitesh. And the thing is, Nitesh, you purchased it just 6 months, but you have driven 12,000 kilometers already.
Yeah.
So it'll be very interesting to get insights from Nitesh. What does he feel about this vehicle? So let's get on with the same. Okay, so we are sitting in your Jeep and this is the 4x4, right?
Yes.
So basically, why did you go for the 4x4? This is my first question, because we also have the regular two-wheel drive in this one.
See, for me, there was actually no requirement for 4x4 or 4x2. That was not my concern. But Jeep was offering in this model, limited edition.
Okay.
The option is only 4x4 if you are going for an automatic and a diesel version.
So all the bells and whistles, you have to go with the 4x4.
Exactly.
But prior to this, which one was the vehicle you were using?
I was using Creta top end. Automatic.
Okay.
Diesel.
So from Creta directly to this one, because Creta is also technically a SUV only.
Yeah.
And this is a better SUV, I know. So what is the main difference that you notice from it? Because Creta is super popular, right?
First, let me clarify one thing to you, Ranjit.
Uh-huh.
This is a popular belief that when people, whenever they want to buy a Jeep, the basic comparison they do with is Creta or Seltos.
Yeah.
And they think Creta or Seltos, they are 10 lakhs cheaper than Jeep.
Yeah, there's a big difference.
But my opinion, after driving Jeep for 12,000 kilometers, this is not the vehicle to be compared to Creta or Seltos.
Okay.
It is to be compared to Audi Q3 or a BMW X1 and then feel that it is 15 lakhs cheaper.
Oh!
So that is a kind of luxury and, you know, the kind of experience you get in this.
But looks like the suspension is good. So you're telling because of the control is better on this car, right?
Braking control is amazing, and diesel racing time takes almost, you know, half of any other vehicles.
Okay.
The normal Cretas or Seltos.
Okay.
So suspensions are very good. You don't even feel the tiredness. Oh. Usually when I used to take my wife to Chevella, because most of my business is in Chevella.
Okay.
We are into real estate.
Oh, nice.
So whenever we do, we go to Chevella. When it was Creta, my wife used to reply, "Kare, main kyun leke ja rahe tak jaungi." In Jeep, she never complained.
So no body roll?
No body roll. Absolutely no body roll. If there are any V-cuts, I'll take that V-cut on a 60 speed feed. 50 speed turn. Absolutely no body roll. Undulation is amazing.
Oh, nice. I can feel that. I can feel that, like, it feels like a German car, because I also drive the... So I can feel that. And again, the braking, we just saw that. Okay, here's some little bit of back patch.
Yeah. And allowed to drive on this bad patch for you to show.
Yeah, we are not slowing down, right?
Yeah.
Let's see, like, okay, the road is almost not there here. We're comfortable. The suspension is not bouncing us here and there. Oh, man.
Before this, actually, I considered a Fortuner.
Okay.
Fortuner, but the body roll was...
I think that's too much, actually.
Too much body roll, and I was looking for comfort and luxury.
Uh-huh. Okay.
This is one trim less than the top version.
Okay.
Top version is called as Model S.
Oh.
They have ventilated seats and they also have this 360 degrees camera.
Okay, okay, got it.
And they have tire measuring monitor.
Okay.
These are the things that really didn't appeal to me to spend 3.5 lakhs more.
Oh.
This is more value for money.
And I think that obviously in Jeep, the diesel one has more power, right?
Yeah. Petrol one has also good power. It's only about the first 2000 RPM where in the turbo lag.
Turbo lag is there, okay. But here, I understand in highway, this is going to be very good at high speed. But what about in city traffic? Like right now, we don't have, but bumper to bumper traffic, how is the feel of this car?
Even city traffic, there is an auto hold.
I love the auto hold.
But this is for the audience.
Okay.
There is an auto hold. And whenever you just take out your feet on from the accelerator, it comes to zero.
Okay.
And it just
stops over there.
You don't have to keep pressing the brake.
Oh, nice.
Beat traffic signals, beat any traffic jam.
Okay.
It works perfectly.
Oh, nice. And the fit and finish here also, it looks good. It's leather, it's soft touch everywhere. So here also interiors, they haven't compromised.
You just hit it, it's not shallow.
It's not shallow. And
if you go to Mahindra XUV 500 or 700, you hit it, the shallowy thing.
And engine, of course, I'm pretty sure the power, there's no lacking in the power. There is there is lag in the certain range, nothing like that.
Nothing like that.
Okay, so pretty happy with the engine.
Pretty happy with it. Actually, my experience started on a very, very bad note.
Okay.
Because I got it in the lockdown. The delivery was, I didn't even get a chance to go to the showroom. It was delivered to me on June 4th.
Oh.
And they had to deliver it to me at doorstep.
Oh.
So I didn't know how to operate the features. At a point, I've seen YouTube videos, but YouTube videos are only for you to guide, not
guide,
to
get guide,
your
guide.
Experience. I was like, अरे मैं क्रेटा बेच के क्या खरीद के लाया, दूसरा क्रेटा ही तो खरीद के लाया हूँ, spending 23-24 lakhs. This vehicle is 32 lakhs, right?
Yeah, it's the high end is expensive.
I sold my Creta at 12 lakhs and spent 20 or whatever. And bloody bullshit, I got the same Creta. But you know, after driving, after the experience, this is something you need to experience it. Paper specs will not justify yeah. that.
So, giving a small test ride to this one, and okay, this is diesel, but I don't feel a lot of, what do you say, sound on this. So, Nitesh, the engine refinement is good, yeah, for a diesel, I would say.
Yeah, yeah, too good.
Feeling comfort. And again, I didn't feel that gear change thing.
Mm.
Oh, so, it's
that, smooth. That's smooth. Only when you're coming down from 80 to 0.
Oh, just suddenly.
Only certain instances.
Oh, okay. This is a comfortable car, I would say. And again, we forgot about this. Again, this has electric seating with memory functions and all those things. We forgot about that. So those are there. Those features are there. Convenience features.
There are two settings for two drivers. You can memorize the seating.
It's a comfortable riding position, actually. Very nice. And doesn't give you that fatigue, right?
No, not at all.
Okay, I'm going to pull this a little bit out.
Fatigue is the last thing.
Oh, it has the pull. I just pulled it. Oh, it has the pull. So overtaking is going to be easy.
I never found any problem with overtaking. It's damn easy.
It's damn easy, and that, what is it, turbo lag kind of a feeling is not there.
Correct.
So that's very important on highways, I feel.
Correct.
And what about the mileage? Because diesel should give a pretty good mileage, right?
Mileage, Creta used to give me in city around 11 kilometers.
That was also diesel?
Diesel.
Okay.
I never drove a petrol vehicle.
Oh.
So, okay. By default, if I'm mentioning about anything, it's a diesel thing.
Okay.
So, Creta used to give me like 11 kilometers in city.
Okay.
On highways, somewhere around 12.5 to 13.5.
Okay.
This is what I used to get. In Jeep, on a highway, I get 13 or 13.5. Oh, a bit more than Creta. But when it is when it comes to city, this gives only 9.8 to 10.
Okay. Not 11. Okay.
So, net you can think about, like, you know, 10 in city and 13 on highway. Basically for me it's a mixed drive.
Okay.
So I'm getting like anywhere between 11 and 11 and a half, and I'm fine with that.
Okay.
Because of the luxury you get out of the vehicle.
And I think so in terms of the interiors, also the dash and all those things, they have given everything. This has Apple CarPlay and Android Auto, right?
Yeah.
So, anything that you feel lacking in, and I like all physical buttons also, instead of like all those touch gimmicks that we are seeing.
Once your muscular memory is formed, it's easy to operate.
Way easier. Okay. The dash, I like it. It's not totally digital, but I like this one. Part, analog and part digital.
Part digital, yes.
I think that this is a better way to do it, because the whole digital thing, I don't understand. So, you're happy with the dash? And I think this is in the high-end model. This the center portion is bigger, or it's on every model, the digital part?
The digital part, in the Model S, it will be a little more bigger.
Actually, even bigger.
Everything will be digital.
Okay, nice.
So, in this, these two parts are analog and the center thing is digital.
Okay, I have one question, and this is very important because you drive it a lot, okay?
Yes.
From a driver's perspective, what do you feel, the dash is good, or do you think ergonomically something could have been better?
No.
It's perfect.
Absolutely perfect.
Perfect, nah? And physical button, so
physical
you don't
buttons,
fiddle around
exactly.
with it.
You don't have to say, hey Siri or okay Google. You just need to press this.
Okay, cool.
The only one thing I would have wished for is, there is no volume increasing button. Not the volume increasing button.
Okay.
Skip and rewind of the song.
Oh.
That was in Creta.
I thought like one doesn't do.
No, this only does the operations of this instrument cluster.
Oh.
And this is speed
cruise control and all.
Control.
Okay.
So that one is missing.
Okay.
So that is the only point that is missing. And if you want to talk about the cons, AC is a weak link.
It's a weak,
When the outside temperature is 34 degrees, it is almost non-existent. And we are working it with the Pride Jeep Hyderabad. I gave the vehicle three times to them. They couldn't fix it because, you know, the time I gave the vehicle is winters.
Now it's feeling pretty cool because we are like
So now they advise me, sir, agar if you believe that there is a problem, come in February or March when the temperature is consistently 34.
Yeah,
the problem is if after 34 when the temperature is completely 34, consistently 34, you just come.
So
there.
Even if you keep it on low, it is not cooling.
Highest fan speed and lowest temperature, it's not cooling.
Okay.
And after 36, I'm literally sweating.
Seriously, this is first time I've heard about this one.
Exactly. Actually, when I wanted to upgrade from a Creta, this is the first thing that we want to have, right?
Creta and all those things, Hyundai, they are giving in ventilated seats and all those things
they are giving.
And okay, let's quickly look at this.
Yeah.
So we have that auto hold function over here.
Yeah.
So here we have the modes between like, but I don't think so here in Hyderabad conditions we need to use all this.
No.
So mostly you just keep it on auto or like standard.
What's
the difference, standard auto? We have standard
So this is not standard. This is sand.
Oh, just sand and mud. Sand and mud. Okay. Did you have any time, because you're traveling this much, had to use this? I think that goes to 4x4 in that.
There were multiple situations where I had to go on sand.
Okay.
But auto mode worked perfectly.
Achai, it does the job.
It never demanded me to...
Achai, manually do that. Oh, that's nice.
Yeah. And the traction control is also auto. Unless you want to switch off the traction control, you need to switch it on here.
Oh. Okay.
If the light is not lit, then the traction control is on auto.
Okay.
And there was multiple purposes, multiple scenarios where there is a huge bit of mire. And you would probably don't dare to go into that.
Okay.
Still, this car, it went in a straight line.
Wow, nice. This is the top, almost the top end. I think so. The base one has 27, 28, something like that.
Base one in diesel starts at 27.
Okay.
In petrol, it starts at 24.
That's 2x2,
yeah,
right?
But petrol, I don't suggest people to buy petrol.
If you're buying, if you're going a highway runs like this, correct, then it doesn't make sense.
See, petrol is also good, but the thing is, it doesn't give you more than 7 kilometers.
Oh, okay.
Day to day, you know, that pinch and prick.
And this color is what, Nitesh?
Gray, they call it some gray, but you know, Ranjit, we are 40 plus people and
we don't care.
Keep a track on that.
So, what about the like wheels? Did you, this is a stock one?
This is a stock one.
And what about the tires? Because you are really driving this one. So, is it good or did you feel like change?
This is a stock tire, Bridgestone Turanza.
Okay.
This is specially made for compact SUVs.
Okay.
Turanza on a sedan is good and on a compact SUV is good.
Okay.
So, these are specially made for Jeep Compass. I'm amazed with the tires and I'm amazed with the wheels.
Okay.
The kind of control that they have. See, it's just not about the braking effect.
Obviously.
When you apply a brake, tire has to support.
Give that traction, right? So from like, obviously, Creta's and this is a huge difference. So I think so you are okay paying that premium. You say it was justified. Initially, you are not able to justify it. But now after driving...
100% justified.
Okay.
My price is 100% justified, Ranjit. I'm telling you one thing.
Okay.
Agar Bhagwan diye bhi na, if I want to go for BMW X3, utna paise agar diye bhi na,
okay,
I will postpone it for next 7 years. Because I just don't want to leave this vehicle. That is the kind of love I developed.
And the confidence it's giving you.
Correct. Initially my thing was, arey kya leke aaya ghar pe, Creta bech ke phir Creta leke aaya. What damn man. But when you're driving, I'm realizing its true potential.
Okay.
So unless you experience for 5 or 6 thousands, you really don't
understand
the driving way. So test drive mein chale jate aap, like you do it like 20 kilometers, 10 kilometers.
Yeah, that's it.
You will not understand anything. The steering and its feedback. 5 to 6 thousand kilometers mein mere ko jitna samajh mein aaya na.
Okay.
32 lakhs is well spent.
Okay. What about the transmission on this one? Are you happy with the transmission gear shift?
There is one confusion for the transmission. Probably it cannot be fixed.
Okay.
But it will not affect you in the day-to-day life.
Okay.
When downshift hona hai, it will take seconds time.
Oh.
Or second time mein zzz bol ke sound jo aata na, that might irritate you, but I got used to it.
Okay.
This is completely that you can ignore and overlook.
So overtaking, you have to take that. Okay, take a split second.
No, overtaking mein nahi.
Oh, okay.
When you're slowing down.
Oh, yeah, okay.
Overtaking, you can overtake anything.
Oh, okay. So what about the servicing? How is the servicing of this in Hyderabad?
Only one service center. So usually people, this is a problem with any dealership that has only one dealership per city, like Benz, Audi, anything.
Yeah, yeah.
Available of spare parts is because they don't do the mass production like Hyundai or...
They won't keep it.
Availability of parts is a challenge.
Okay.
Maybe Hyundai mein aapko 4 din mein service ho jata to, isme to 8-10 din lagi jayega.
Okay.
That's one thing. But the beauty of the vehicle is it doesn't go to the workshop.
Okay.
That's one thing. And the workshop people are very responsive.
Oh, nice.
And they just call and follow up. It's an amazing experience.
It's actually a good experience, actually.
Yeah. Two days back, I called Chennai Service Center because after taking the vehicle for the AC problem for three times to Pride Jeep, Hyderabad Wala,
okay,
they were unable to fix it. And they asked me to come down in February.
Oh, okay.
I spoke to Chennai guys. Chennai people know that I'm not their customer.
Right.
Still, the response was amazing. They are following up with the highest teams. Okay. Sir, Hyderabad se jo banda aya, he's facing problem with AC. This what particular can we do?
Oh, nice.
Ultimately, they came up with some sort of solution. And they spoke to Hyderabad people. Oh. And now vehicle is going to Hyderabad thing only.
Oh, nice.
So it is that kind of coordination.
Oh, that is actually nice to hear.
Yes, and you never find that in Suzuki or Hyundai.
Obviously.
They just fight among themselves. Sir, Radha Krishna mein kyun beche?
You come to us. It's basically holding the client to a particular... So, from what it gives me the impression... And what... Okay, this won't be an issue, but I have to ask you. What about the ground clearance on this one?
Ground clearance has never been an issue.
Nothing, no?
I'll tell you one. There has been a... YouTube mein generally... hum log dekhte na wo... kya concept... driving track create kare sabhe jeep wale se.
Okay.
And we drove our compasses in that.
Oh,
and
nice.
You had to go deep like this and come like this.
Okay.
Obviously, I don't know the numbers.
But no issues at all. No, in 12,000 kilometers, nowhere it bumped.
In 12,000 kilometers, I did not hit my chassis anywhere.
Oh, nice.
And I'm a very fast driver.
I've noticed, like speed breakers, okay, let's... see, the car is giving you that confidence.
Correct. So, I never faced that problem.
So, let's say if you have to rate it, 1 being the worst, 10 being the best, how would you rate this car?
Honestly, Ranjit, it should be more than 10.
Wow, this is like...
People shouldn't think me that I'm bad.
Okay.
I'm giving it 10 on 10.
Oh, nice. So, you're totally satisfied. That's a very rare combination because in every vehicle, you feel that something is right or wrong.
Correct.
So, what's the warranty that default, Jeep India is giving?
1 lakh kilometers and 3 years.
Achha, 3 years they are giving.
3 years and 1 lakh kilometers, whichever is earlier. And you also have the option of buying the extended warranty for 5 years or 150,000 kilometers, whichever is earlier.
Okay. And what are the service typical cost on this?
For me, the first cars, they didn't charge me anything apart from the AdBlue oil and all.
Okay.
But the typical cost would be, because I have quite a few Jeep friends.
Okay.
So the cost for service to service should be around 18,000 to 20,000.
Okay. And that includes oil change, everything. And it's once a year and 10,000 kilometers?
15,000 kilometers.
Oh, 15?
Normally, if you take a Creta, it is for 10,000 kilometers.
Yeah, yeah.
This is for 15,000 kilometers.
Okay.
Maintenance is at a little expensive side.
Okay, obviously.
Jeep comes into a luxury.
Car. So overall, Ditesh looks like a very happy customer of Jeep.
Yeah.
Let's hope your AC thing is solved.
Thank you. Fingers
crossed. Okay, guys. So that was the user review of the Jeep Compass. Again, a beautiful vehicle. In fact, Nitesh, when I was considering a BMW, this was one of the vehicles I was looking at.
Okay.
But I'm personally a sedan guy. That is the thing.
Right, right.
But I think so for Indian roads, the ground clearance matters, man.
Amazing.
So anyways, Nitesh, thanks a lot for this video and taking out your time for coming. And guys, these are the user reviews. This is what I love. Getting the feedback from the end user. And I'm very happy that you have given such a high rating to a Jeep Compass and you have driven it a lot. Thanks, Nitesh, for sharing your experience.
Thank you for having me here.
Anyways, guys, take care. Catch you later. Bye-bye.